Hi, good afternoon and welcome to Your Stocks. I'm Sumaira Abdi and with me is my colleague Nigel D'Souza. Well, for the market, it's a day of underperformance from the globe. So we're seeing the frontline indices take a bit of a knock and of course the mid-cap index faring far worse. But at least between the mid-caps and the large-caps, the gap seems to have lessened.
Well, that's right, Sumaira. Well, plenty of stocks to talk about and plenty of queries we will be receiving. So let's bring in our guests first. Joining us today, we have Mayuresh Joshi and Kiran Jadhav to answer all your stock queries. Thanks, gentlemen, for joining in today. And let's get straight to our first query. We have Shriyasi, who writes to us from New Delhi. He wants to know if it is okay to sell Bharti Airtel stock right now. And what's the target price, I believe, out there? Mayuresh, let's come across to you. That stock, you know, it's been actually the Valentine's Day stock. I was looking at the stock over the weekend. Last Valentine's Day, it was at a 52-week low. This Valentine's Day, it's at a 52-week high. So it's doubled your money. That would have been the best Valentine's gift if someone got it. But what about the query that we're getting in there on Bharti Airtel? What would your view be from here?
After the Nigel, afternoon, Sumaira. Oh, absolutely, I think the best Valentine gift that one could have received. But largely, again, I think the caveat in terms of time horizons that the investor probably has in terms of the holding limits is something which is very, very critical. Now, whatever we are going through in terms of AGR, AGR dues, the QIP which Bharti has raised, it's got almost 21,000 crores in terms of its cash kitty at this point of time, so against dues of 36,000 crores that it needs to pay out. So I think it is trying to raise capital to pay off its dues. It's also raised its pre-tariffs before the verdict came out. So I think the ARPU increase should be substantial going forward and capex intensity will come down. However, as per the query that the user probably wants, I think the stock is already up 16%, up from the pivot levels that our methodology suggests. So ideally, I think we ideally book profits between 22 and 25 odd percent from the pivot move. So 605, 610 are the levels as per our studies that we would ideally recommend profit booking if the pivot levels of 485 have been adhered to in terms of buying. Kiran probably can give you better levels in terms of exit points.
Okay, Mayuresh, first to you on Coal India and then on PFC, what would you advise our investor to do?
Afternoon, Sumer, again. So I think, yes, I think the price performance has been very, very disappointing for both these stocks and for valid reasons as well. So if you probably look at the output itself and the expectations, again, largely are 600 to 625 in terms of optic volumes for Coal India. And again, the realizations have been on the lower side for the quarter gone by because of extended monsoons. The reported EBITDA per 350 rupees. Again, I think that should probably stagnate around the same levels as well. So I think it's going to be a very tough year for Coal India as well. Though there might be rebound in terms of offtake in quarter four and expectations of e-auction revenues actually inching higher. That would probably suffice in terms of EBITDA per ton moving higher. But again, I think the problems related to balance sheet and price performance still stay. Dividend is something that the stock can still give out and valuations are extremely cheap. So 6 times FY21, 2.5 times EBITDA, dividend yield of 8% still probably looks attractive at these levels. But again, I think price performance as per our cancelling methodology still suggests that there might be better stocks to go out for. So you might probably hit out if any dividend adjustment is done. But PI Industries is something that we'll continue to like. It's a stock that perfectly fills our cancelling methodology. Earnings has been extremely strong. They've introduced new products like Apkira in terms of the herbicide. The acquisition of Isagro is probably going to prop up ROEs in excess of 22% odd. And they're getting into new businesses which can actually fuel balance sheet expansion significantly. So again, PI Industries is something that we recommend for the target and stop loss mentioned. PFC, again, I think the classical problems faced by this power financer has been well known. I think the exposure towards the private sector, the gross three assets that they've probably reported, the provisioning needed to do and the GNPAs that they have reported has probably not instilled confidence and the earnings momentum has probably got beleaguered because of all these issues. But again, I think the investor can probably continue holding on to PFC with the expectations of resolutions for a few cases in NCLT. But again, I think he has to watch out for levels of 117, which is a very close support of 50 daily moving average, because if that breaks with volumes, our methodology suggests that the stock can go further. So I think he can probably keep that as a stop loss for PFC.
Well, let's get to our next query. We have Rajiv, who writes to us from Lucknow. He holds around 1,500 shares of J&K Bank at around 29 rupees. Long-term investor wants to know whether or not to hold or to sell. And additional detail, he's got 1,500 shares of J&K Bank. Mayuresh, let's come across to you. What would your view be on J&K Bank? He bought it at around 29 rupees. He believed that, in fact, maybe it's corrected enough. He's lost more money. What should he do now?
So again, Nigel, you're absolutely right. I think instead of holding on to losing trades, what our cancelling methodology suggests is to pick out leaders and pick out winners where price momentum and action is getting supported through earnings growth. So largely for J&K Bank, the GNPAs have shot up to 11-odd%. You've probably seen a restructured book of almost 4,000 crores, which can still go bad, which probably still means that the asset quality pressures might still continue on their balance sheet. Return ratios are actually in negative terrain. So largely again, yes, you probably need to take a tough call, but you need to take that call in terms of earnings momentum not returning very, very soon. So my suggestion would be, I think, to look at alternative stocks. If you're probably looking within the banking industry itself, Nigel, for the investor, HDFC Bank is something that we'll still continue to recommend. NIMS at 4.2%, you're still seeing asset quality, which is extremely stable at 1.42 in terms of gross NPAs. Advances growth at 20% can very well continue over the next few quarters, aptly supported by deposit growth of 20-odd% as well. And outstanding return ratios because of all these parameters. So Tier 1 ratio stays extremely robust at 17.5%, ROA at 2%, ROE at 16.5%. So my suggestion would be to exit the J&K Bank and probably look at HDFC Bank for the target and stop loss mentioned.
Okay, the next query comes in from Mayank Saraf, who's written to us from New Delhi. He has 300 shares of Akzo Nobel, which he has bought at 2100. He's a long-term investor and wants to know whether to hold or to sell. So currently making a bit of money over here. But Mayuresh, on Akzo Nobel, what would the call be? And for somebody who's already in the money, can they hope for more upside from here?
So Sumana, they can hold on to the stock because numbers in terms of top line were a tad bit disappointing. But what they probably achieved in terms of optimization of input costs clearly played out on the operating front. So the EBITDA performance was quite exemplary, and expecting crude and crude derivatives to stay extremely soft, which basically means that as volume growth starts coming back, because they largely cater to the auto and the real estate sector, as that starts coming back, there can be substantial growth that can come through from an earnings perspective. So what we've seen at our in our methodology at Sper O'Neill, I think the EPS growth has been quite substantial. What you're probably seeing and expected to see in terms of price action through the RSI is quite good as well. So yeah, he can hold on to the stock. But an alternative within the same thing might be Asian Paints, which has a leadership position in the decorative paint segment. It has a reasonable amount of capacity expansion that they have done. Earnings growth is extremely strong, and return ratios are way above our recommended averages of 17.5 at 25.5. So yeah, he can hold on to Akzo Nobel. An alternative stock within this from a buying perspective would be Asian Paints.
Okay, Mayuresh, what about you? What's your take?
So when I think if you adjust our cancelling methodology, I think earnings are extremely poor. So Kiran is absolutely right on that one. When you're probably talking about institutional holding, which you clearly follow, I think there is absolutely no institution holding in Centrum and the other stock as well, which is Gulf Petroleum. And again, I think that is reflected in lower ROEs. So my suggestion would be, I think, to look at an alternative stock like Sudarshan Chemicals, because we do like the specialty chemical space from a sector rotation perspective. And what we've probably seen in terms of reported numbers, EBITDA margins at 15.5% for the 9-month period, expectations of debt equity coming down from 0.6. And again, I think a strong leadership position. They are the number one player in pigmentation in India. I think export orders are significantly improving, and exports is 48-odd%, which is reflected in ROEs, which are 24-25%. So again, I think if one has to choose, I think you can exit, probably look at Sudarshan Chemical from the specialty chemical space.